week I was watching the TV with my daughter. We were looking at the Fantastic Four movie, and it was really interesting for me to think how all of us are in love with superheroes, with super senses that allow people to do things that other people cannot do. My name is Bendetto Vigna. I am an Italian guy. I studied at university in Pisa, where the Lying Tower is. I'm originally a physicist, but the life brought me in a different place to develop sensors. And this kind of tiny object enable you to do crazy things. We've been always trying to augment our senses. And this goes way back to 2,500 years ago, when people start to use the compass, the device telling you where is north, east, south, or west. 100 years ago, the motion sensor were 1,000 times more expensive, 1,000 times more difficult to manufacture, and 1,000 times bigger than they are today. So to go from big to small, we were looking for inspiration, and we took inspiration from a very nice building in Japan. I was in Kyoto in 2005, and I saw a pagoda, the Toji Pagoda, that is the tallest pagoda we have in the world. And this pagoda has been able to cope with all the earthquakes that Japan has seen in the last centuries. We took inspiration from this design to make very robust M.E.M.S, micro electromechanical systems, able to cope with all the manufacturing steps that were required to make these pieces in the billions at very affordable cost. And this kind of idea has been implemented in all the sensors that we are producing in the last decade. Motion sensors are by far the most widely used sensor in the world. In the phone in our pocket, we have several sensors. We have a motion sensor, you have a microphone, you have a touchscreen. The detection of the motion enables you to interact with the external world in a more intuitive way. One of the recent developments in user interface, which has revolutionized gaming, is the use of gesture and movement recognition. The whole body participates in the experience and not just the thumbs. The opportunity to work with Nintendo came because we had a motion sensor ready for their Wii controller. This sensor was ready because I remember at the time in my team there was a person with reduced motor skills that was not able to play video games in a traditional button way. The result of this cooperation with Nintendo was a true revolution in the way we play games. Everyone now can play games in a normal way, in an intuitive way, without being an octopus around the controller. Sensor can also augment everyday objects. Think about the bracelet. In the past, it was only used to remind you that someone was close to your heart. Now, a bracelet can remind you to take care of your heart. Consider also the glasses. In the past, they only used to help you see clearly, but now they can give us a new way of looking at the world. For sure, sensors are bridging the gap between the man and the external world. But sensors do another important thing. They give us more insight into the world where we live. We can do more with less because we can optimize better the use of energies. All of us are in love at any age with superheroes, with super senses that allow people to do things that other people, normal people, cannot do. M.E.M.S can bring a new dimension to the future of storytelling. We don't need any more button, we don't need any more punch card or keyboard. We just have to be more human, and the device around us will understand what we want to do with them. We have barely scratched the surface. We are living in exciting times, and this is only the beginning of something truly amazing.